How to interview a .NET developer or application architect? My name is Vikas Kearney. I have more than 20 years of experience in IT industry. I am TOGAF certified architect. Do subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Hello friends. Today I will show you my interviewing technique. I have more than 20 years of experience. I get to interview a lot of web-based .NET developers. So this is a format I used to use. Now I do more a different theme-based interview. I'll post another video for that. So let me go through how I used to interview the people. And how do I find out the level of the person, whether the person is a developer or architect? I used to be in the consulting also, so I have a lot of experience of being interviewed and interviewing the candidates. So I have been on the both side, ask the web-based technology questions to understand how much the web technology the candidate knows. Some questions: what is the difference between response.redirect and server.transfer? How do you maintain state? What is the difference between application state and session state? This is very interesting question. It shows very much the depth of .NET technology, especially ASP.NET. What is the difference between caching versus application state? What are the difference between HTTP handler and HTTP module? And it's very advanced question. And I do realize with the AngularJS, some of these questions are obsolete. That's why I have changed the format, but we'll continue this one. So if somebody answers this question, HTTP handler and HTTP module, that tells me the candidate has very advanced knowledge of the web technologies. So then let's come to .NET questions. .NET, I ask some questions which tells me the depth of the .NET technology the candidate has. Some questions are: what is the difference between string versus string builder, data reader versus data set, dispose versus finalize, garbage collection. So once these questions are answered, and generally I ask JavaScript question before that, so I am okay with the candidate. I know he qualified as a programmer. Then I go for the advanced level. Then I ask the interface programming. Basically, I'm asking more object-oriented programming questions. And I used to ask in JavaScript jQuery some questions to understand how much depth of jQuery the candidate has. Now we have replaced these questions with AngularJS. So once these questions are answered, this is very advanced level. So if you are looking for your career, how to progress as an advanced developer. So these are the techniques which tells me the candidate is designer or architect. Does he know test-driven development? Does he know what is mocking? What framework has used? Have he used any design patterns? What are the design patterns he have used? What is dependency injection? What are the solid principles? And then finally, what is a service-oriented architecture? Now, I think I won't ask what is a service-oriented architecture. I will ask about the microservices architecture. The answering of these questions tells me that even if the person has been working on cloud computing or not cloud computing, answering these advanced questions shows me too much commitment towards the software engineering and software passion. thank you very much for watching this video. If you like the video, subscribe to my channel. And this is like you can, these tips you can use to plan your interview. Thanks for watching this video. If you like the video, do subscribe to my channel for your regular updates. Thank you very much.